Hello everybody and welcome to this new video of detail painting with Krita. In this case, I'm not going to be talking about brushes. How weird, Raymond not talking about brushes. In this case, I'm going to talk about perspective. Krita has very powerful tools to manage the perspective. This is going to be a really, really interesting video because we are going to talk about how to use the vanishing point and a couple of tricks that maybe you didn't know. Are you ready? Here we go. Okay, so here we go. Now we're gonna learn how to use the vanishing point assistant in Krita. If we go here to the assistant tool, we can see nothing happens. Apparently nothing happens. But in the tool options locker, we can see these parameters. And if I click on the canvas right now, I get this. So as you can see, I can move drawing from here. I can move it. Or I can toggle the visibility if I'm going to use it or not in this moment, or I can delete. Pretty easy, pretty fast. So I create a new vanishing point and I can see my density of lines is controlled by 15 degrees. But if I need more precision in the artwork, I can reduce this to 1 degree to control better how I see the lines inside my picture. Normally, we are not going to be so close to this part of the vanishing point assistance. We are working more around this area, okay? But there is a way that we can change this view, and it's controlling the opacity. So if I reduce the opacity, this moire effect disappears a bit. If I reduce the opacity, I can barely see the lines. But because I'm using this kind of gray color, if I create another vanishing point, I can change the density. And as you can see, remembers the global color opacity. But wait, what happens if I go right here and start drawing with this kind of grid? It may be confused in some ways because sometimes I don't know if I can go to the X axis or in Y axis. So one thing that I do is just to give a custom color. So if I select this, I can control here the custom color and I select, okay, this is going to be my Y axis. So I select the green for that and then reduce the opacity around the 25%. Okay. For me is quite enough. I reduce the opacity again to 30% or 25%, maybe something like that. Okay. And now when I go closer, I can see very, very fast what axis I'm using in any position. Okay. No problem. I not get lost with this. And as you can see, there's a little problem that I'm going to explain right now. How can we align two different vanishing points? Well, very easy. To do that, we need to use the guidelines. Okay, so we go to the view, so rulers, and this appears. I click and drag from here to establish my horizon line. Okay, and then I just make click here and I get closer and I drag from here, not from here, because if I use this, as you can see, it doesn't snap. I have to be sure that is snapped to the guides, okay? And drag from this point, okay? I can just relocate this to not be affected by the snap to, okay? And also I can use this and it's a snapping to this point. So I get this and I get this and I have my first vanishing point snapped to the guideline. Okay, I create another one. So I do this and I create this alignment and this one. Okay, this way we have perfectly aligned two different vanishing points. Is it? Also, something that can happen to you is that you create the vanishing point and then you have a 1 point hidden by this kind of widget. So how can I use this point? Because sometimes it's important. we will see in a minute, okay? So what can I do? I can go like zoom in and then I see again this point and I go here and I snap to the guy. It's not a super cool trick, but I think it's making your life easier in some moments. Another thing that can happen is that if you have something like this, or you are going to try to make a parallel ruler, how do I make it to create a perfect straight line? Create initial point and then press shift key, and then it's perfectly straight to my surface, okay? Or I can use this technique, which is I make the parallel ruler near to the corner or the document, it's automatically align it to the document. Pretty easy, pretty fast. And what happens if I accident, I move maybe my points, maybe I mess everything on my assistance. So there is no worry about this because I can make Ctrl C and do, and I get all my assistance to initial points. So I think this is pretty useful. A common mistake is to make something like this. It's too near one vanishing point from the other vanishing point. This create this kind of very, very unreal lines that can affect a lot of drawing, okay? So it's better to move this, just using this and pressing shift to restrict the movement to the x-axis and locate one of the vanishing points outside or two vanishing points outside of the artwork, okay? And now is when you see that the density is really useful because I can move my density to 2 degrees or 3 degrees. And now I need another one vanishing point, which I place here. And this is my vanishing point for the height of the building, okay? So I can do this, I can make zoom out and then press shift and do something like this. Okay, I select custom color, blue, and the opacity and the density reduced to 2. Okay, and now I have a perfect grid for my drawing in perspective. But what if I need to make another illustration? I can go here and I can save my assistant to something like this, like test 3 points, and I save. Okay, and now I create a new picture with the same size, and I create, and then I go to my assistants and I import my arrangement for this setup, okay? It's pretty easy and pretty fast, I think. How cool is that? So now it's time for drawing. Use these as visual guidelines, okay? So I'm not snapping anything. I can do whatever I want, but using these as guidelines, maybe we want more accuracy. So for that, I use the snap to assistance. I'm going to use the setting as this one. And snap single is if I have different assistants, it only snaps to the first assistant that detects the brushstroke, okay? So now I can draw perfectly and you can see the difference, okay? So let me know in the comments if perspective is useful for you or this is something that we need to go deeper. And as you can see, I need to activate or deactivate because if I need to create like tilted plane, it's not possible. It's totally snapping to my grid. So I need to deactivate and I can do, it's snap single, snap to the assistance. And I can do this kind of drawing. It's a free drawing, okay? But this is not comfortable. So there is a shortcut that you can use. It's in configure Krita, shortcut, and snap. You can see the snap to assistance. By default is Ctrl+Shift+L, so I configure to use a customized shortcut for this one. If you want to customize the shortcut, you just press here on the none and then just select the key that you want to use, and maybe a key like G, and you see something like this. It's in conflict because G is already used for draw a gradient, okay? So you cancel and you find another shortcut like this, or a combination like this, or whatever you want to assign to the shortcut. I use this because it's near to my Ctrl+C and I can control much better this way. Maybe you are wondering, why are these handles useful for? In this kind of situation, the vanishing point of the height is really, really far away. So it's not so easy to find the vanishing point just by sight. So we need to use these tools, these handles, because they are gonna help us to find the vanishing point. I move this closer to find this point and find this point. And as you can see, if I move now this point, this vanishing point is adjusting itself to find the right location of that point. So if I move here just to that corner, and I go here and align to that corner, and I use the same technique here, I can find the perfect vanishing point for this photograph, for example. And if I reduce this to the maximum, I can see that my vanishing point is far away. Okay, now let's go for a simple trick. Okay, how can we divide this surface by two? Press the V key to change temporarily to line tool. Okay, start by this corner and crossing the surface like this. Okay, and now we do the same right here, and now I get this point, which is the center in perspective of this surface, with another color, and I get something like this. And if you see, maybe it's not so accurate, so I displace pressing the Alt key, my line, and I move it to this point. Pretty easy, pretty fast. How about to divide this surface by three? If we press the V key again, so now we can have the centers, but this divides the surface by four, okay? But it's not what we want. So what can we do? Well, you can guess the solution, but let's make it more clear, okay? Because I have this point where the first diagonals were crossing with the second diagonals, okay? We can have right now moving exactly where we want to move the line, okay? So maybe this, and done. You have this surface divided by three. Let's go for something a bit more complicated, but at the same time is more useful. First of all, we need to find this point, okay? And this point is what we call a measure point, okay? And now we can use also another color, and maybe another layer, and we draw a line here, something like this, and it's coming from the nearest point of us on this surface, okay? And then I just create a line from the measured point crossing the surface to the more distant part from our eyes, and we find this point, and this point is crossing the surface with the horizon line. You can be so accurate as you want, but you get the point, okay? Now we have these points, and these points are what we need to create the divisions right here, okay? It can solve a lot of different situations, but you can place, for example, windows, doors, whatever. I hope you like it. And that's all for now. Happy painting, and if you want to stay tuned, activate the notification bell. See you in the next video. Bye.